Hello. Today we will be talking about web services scanning with Fortify on Demand version 20.4. I'll show you how you can complete a scan of your web services as part of a dynamic plus assessment, where you may test the web services utilized by the application or as an automated web services scan. Both scan types require sample data provided by your development team. Then later in the video, I'm going to be sharing important information on how to prepare your project files for each type of scan using different file types. So be sure to stick around for those important practices we recommend for faster, more accurate scans. Let's start with scanning web services as part of a Dynamic Plus assessment. On the screen, we have the Dynamic Scan Configuration Settings page. So let's go through the options. First, you'll choose Dynamic Plus Web Services Assessment and enter the URL for your application. Next, after entering any of the scope and authentication information required for your specific application, expand the Web Services section and enable Web Services. As part of a Dynamic Plus Web Services assessment, Fortify on Demand supports SOAP and RESTful endpoints. I'm going to be covering an example of each later, but for now, we'll choose REST. From here, we require you to provide a file that contains working sample data to describe the endpoints. This will typically be your Postman collection or other API definition files, but we also support Swagger JSON definition files as well. As you can see, I've already uploaded my Postman collection. From here, simply add your file along with any additional instructions for the tester, along with authentication values such as username, password, and API key. Once all of those settings have been entered, complete the assessment configuration by scheduling any of the other details for the tester. Save your settings, and then start your scan. Now let's talk about an automated scan of your web services. Going back to the top of the settings page, I'm going to change the assessment type to Dynamic Web Services Assessment. Now, when we expand the Web Services section, we'll only see Postman and OpenAPI options as the Web Services type. You may choose either a file of either type or provide a URL. From here, upload your file or enter the URL, save your settings, and start the scan. When completing a web services assessment, it's important to know how best to prepare your project files. Our product documentation has an entire page dedicated to this, but I'll go ahead and cover some of the most important considerations now. As I said before we can complete a proper security test, we must have project files that have working sample data. If you don't have files with working sample data, reach out to your QA or development team. They usually have these and can provide them for testing purposes. For SOAP endpoints, let's look at an example that highlights the requirements. This is an example of a web service definition language file loaded in the SOAP UI, has working parameter values as well. This example has 4 requests with correct input values, which are the ones framed in red, and the corresponding responses from the web services framed in green. Now, as a REST example, this shows a RESTful API endpoint loaded in the Postman UI. The endpoint handles authentication for the application, where you see the request with the username and password framed in red, and the response from the application framed in green. It's important to note Postman environment files are not supported. For RESTful endpoints, you must provide an API definition, such as an OpenAPI file or the Postman collection file. Now, before we wrap up the video, I'd like to point you towards our extensive documentation we have that covers web services scanning, as you see here, as part of the overall guidance for dynamic scan configuration. You'll see an entire section with multiple dropdowns covering the different types of assessments, some of which we've talked about today. We also have sections specifically on preparing web services project files, and this expands on the topics touched on in this video as well. Now that's it for scanning your web services with Fortify on Demand. So be sure to subscribe to this channel for other helpful videos like this. And we would appreciate a thumbs up on the video if you feel it was helpful and you understand now how to leverage Fortify on Demand for web services scanning.